There are three national monuments designed by a contest. They commemorate three great milestones that define the history of the Philippines. The first is the monument that represents Jose Rizal and the era that fostered the concept of a free Filipino nation. Second is the monument to Andres Bonifacio, which symbolizes the revolution of 1896. Third is the monument to Manuel L. Quezon, which signifies the modern Filipino nation as we know today. The effort initiative to build the Quezon Memorial Shrine began in 1945, when President Sergio Osmeña created the Quezon Memorial Committee. The committee was tasked to raise funds and hold the design contest for a national monument for Quezon, which was won by architect Federico Illustre. In 1952, the construction of the shrine began. The memorial is highlighted by a 66-meter trilon monument at the heart of Quezon City's most important park. The height of the monument represents Quezon's age when he passed away. The three columns and angels bowed in grief, holding sampaguita wreaths, represent the country's main islands, Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. The columns are made of reinforced concrete, clad in the finest Bianco Carrara marble. At its base is a spacious triangular hall that features bas-relief panels with scenes from the Spanish colonial period until Quezon's presidency. At its base chamber is the mausoleum where the remains of Quezon and his wife, Aurora Aragon Quezon, were interred. Within this shrine and museum, we will find objects and artifacts pertaining to the many stories of the unrivaled legacy of Manuel L. Quezon. The story begins on August 19, 1878, when Quezon was born in the sleepy town of Baler to teachers Lucio Quezon, a Tagalog from Paco, and Maria Dolores Molina, a Spanish mestiza from Baler. At 9 years old, he was brought to Manila as a messboy to study at Colegio de San Juan de Letran. As a student, he successfully graduated with an AB degree, summa cum laude, and with a title, experienced surveyor and appraiser of lands. He further pursued law studies as a working student at the University of Santo Tomas in 1895. When the Philippine-American War broke out, Quezon joined the military as an aide-de-camp. As a soldier, he was promoted to first lieutenant and later on assigned to the general staff of President Aguinaldo. He rose the ranks from captain to major. When news came of President Aguinaldo's capture, Quezon's mission was to verify this news. He surrendered in order to confirm the capture of the president. He remained in American custody for nearly 6 months. When he was released, Quezon resumed his law studies and started working at Monte de Piedad as a clerk. He laid down his arms, but he never laid down his zeal for freedom. Quezon ran for governor of Tayabas and won. He was later elected as the representative of Tayabas to the Philippine Assembly and later became majority floor leader. He was then elected as resident commissioner to represent the Philippines in the U.S. House of Representatives. He helped in the enactment of the Jones Law, which paved the way to Philippine independence. He holds the distinction of being the first and longest-serving Senate President of the Philippines. In 1918, he married Aurora Aragon Quezon in a solemn ceremony in Hong Kong. Led several independence missions to prove the capacity of the Philippines to govern itself. The result of these missions is considered one of his greatest achievements. He opposed the Hair Hoss Cutting Act in favor of the ratification of the Tidings McDuffie Act. This act paved way to a 10-year transitional government called the Commonwealth, which scheduled Philippine independence for July 4, 1946. Quezon was elected first president of the Commonwealth in 1935. Quezon's administration advocated three core concepts: national defense, economic growth, and efficient government. He pioneered economic programs and policies and established numerous departments. He implemented educational reforms and institutionalized Filipino as a national language. He instituted public utilities, including the Manila Railroad Company, which facilitated efficient transportation from Bicol to Manila. Quezon was re-elected to the presidency in November 1941. The country was content and at peace until the sudden invasion of the Empire of Japan on December 8, 1941. When war broke out, Quezon was a symbol of hope and freedom for the Filipino people. To continue the fight, he moved his government to the fortress island of Corregidor and eventually to the United States at the advice of Field Marshal Douglas MacArthur. In the United States, he established the Commonwealth Government in Exile and served on the Pacific War Council. Through him, the Philippines joined the United Nations, receiving recognition as an allied nation. He tirelessly campaigned to hasten the rescue of the Philippines. He would never get to see the freedom come to pass. On August 1, 1944, President Quezon died of tuberculosis at Saranac Lake, New York. He was accorded with special honors in Washington, D.C., and was temporarily buried in Arlington Cemetery. Finally, on July 4, 1946, Quezon's dream of an independent Republic of the Philippines was fulfilled. The lowering of the American flag and the raising of the Philippine flag symbolized the freedom of the Philippines from the United States through the efforts and selfless dedication of Manuel L. Quezon. On July 27, 1946, Quezon's remains finally came home. He was buried in the North Cemetery on August 1, 1946. 33 years after, Quezon's remains were transferred to the Quezon Memorial Shrine, the president's final resting place. Today, this shrine remains a testament to a great life devoted to the happiness and freedom of the Filipino people that led to the formation of the modern republic we know today. As Manuel Rojas eloquently put it, we are a free people and a free nation in large part because of him.